What up, everybody? Sorry, I'm a little late here. But Jersey, how's it going?
Pretty darn good. How about yourself?
Good, man. I didn't update my app. I'm an idiot, right? So I know I can hear you now. After the music plays, I won't be able to hear you. I just know it's going to happen. I was like, oh, I'll leave while the music's playing. But you dumbass, you're the one playing the music. So I'm going to roll the dice, all right? All right, guys. We'll wait for everyone to get in. Now, look, when I first came on the scene and started doing these AMAs on Monday and the wrap-ups, there was like a song I was drawn to, Gosh, He's My Year, right? And relating it to Hoge. And I think we're very close to running it back 360 style. Only this time, as I've mentioned a billion times, our product suite continues to grow and sharpen. And there's a lot of good going on behind the scenes that, you know, whether it's fortunate or not, doesn't show on the charts. But I think we're lining our ducks up in a row. And I really think from today on, the next 365 days is going to be Hoge's year in all reality. So let's let Gashi and G-Eazy kick off the vibe and energy for 3 minutes 16 seconds, and then we'll get into it.
That bitch rolling up, you know she ain't rolling all by herself. She just wanna fuck, pull up in the crib with your girls on my bed like. Out in Vegas high, all up in the wind, fucking bitches out the window like. She ain't getting tired, riding on my dick on the. I'm hot now, I could never flop now. Probably getting quap now, made it off the block now. Do it for my hometown, made it with my own sound. Every single city you mention me, yeah, they know now. What I'm reaching for, cop your Bentley truck.
Kendall Jenner, your pockets just got light bulb. Flood my teeth, I'm sipping whiskey, my ice cold. New Rolly Poly, that's 35 for that white gold. Chain saw the beat, just got American Psycho. Hot now, that mean you should stop now. Pull up in that drop now, click it, put the top down. Decepticon to Rory, just to show out on the block now. Had to tint the window, she can't stop giving me top now. I'm rich as fuck, cop the Lambo truck. No boo pulling up, plate that up. Dipped up out of there, we're headed back to fuck. Rich as fuck, let's just get this clear. This gon' be my year, every year. Back to back to back for like my whole career.
This my year. This gon' be my year. This gon' be my year. This my year. This gon' be my year. This gon' be my year. My year. My year. This gon' be my year. This gon' be my year. This my year. This gon' be my year. This gon' be my year. My year. My year. I always stay lucky. All these bitches so nosy. Used to sit up in those bleeds. Now we watching for four seats. I keep on grinding. Swaggy got the keys timing. If I like it, I cop it. Hand out like y'all when I ride. My key is shot. 50,000. Cop the whip.
That brings back some memories, I'm gonna tell you right now. And I like those memories, man. It's before we had the product suite, but we had the share of voice, we had the culture, and now we've got that depth. So time really is our only variable. But happy Friday, Hoge Nation. You know, you ever thought about the mix of personalities, skill sets, and professionals that make up our great community? I mean, whether we're anon ladies or anon gentlemen, we're all dopamine artists of the digital domain. We make up a merry mix of mavens and misfits, all on a mission to master the mystical art of success. And how do we find that success, you ask? Now look, there are many ways to find the success treasure chest, but how do we find it somewhere, and what do we do? Well look, one clear way is by taking this platform, X, by the horns, of course. Now, X isn't a dreaded X lover or a treasure map spot. It's this social media platform of untapped potential that is home to our unexplored opportunities and our underutilized assets. So buckle up, buckle in, as we embark on the express train to Successville. There are some simple steps to follow. Step one, define your TalkX, right? It could be your knack for networking, your expertise in exoplanets, or your passion for foot fetish videos. Whatever it is, own it, harness it, make it your superpower. Step two, be proactive and consistent. You know, like a gym goer on January 1st, attend webinars as if they're Coachella, network like you're on a speed dating marathon, and stay active on social media as if your life depends on it, like a child, because let's face it, it kind of does. Step three, embrace rejection, right? It's the universe's way of saying, not this way, buddy, try another route. Think of it as a redirection, not a rejection. It's a detour, not a dead end. Every no you get, it just brings you closer to that yes. So take that no, make it your stepping stone, and keep it moving. You see, our life clock is ticking faster than a meme going viral, so don't waste your time nursing that precious ego. Step four, learn from your mistakes. They're not failures, they're life lessons in disguise, kind of like Transformers. Just like Batman, they might seem scary at first, but they're actually here to help. Embrace them, learn from them, and use them to improve. Remember, the road to success is paved with potholes of mistakes. So buckle up. It's going to be a bumpy ride, and that's if you're lucky. And step five, assemble your all-star team, like the Great Hoge Nation. With your defined TalkX, your consistent efforts, your resilience to no's, and your learnings from mistakes, you're ready to form that perfect team. Think of it as the Avengers, but with less spandex. Together, we're all unstoppable. So folks, that's one of my blueprints for finding success right here on the X Free Thing app we call X. So it's time to roll up our sleeves, put on those unreasonable thinking caps, and dive into the realm of unlimited possibilities. Welcome to the wrap-up report, right? Where X marks the spot and success is our true treasure. And speaking of treasures, one of the great Hoge treasures, Mr. Jersey Rax, is back with another segment on the Hoge News of the Week.
I piss. Tell him I'm Harlem, oh, oh, oh. Harlem, holy, Kenneth and baby, starving the would be flow. AD do snowing, oh. Biscuit do green like groves.
Woo, Jersey, will I be able to hear you?
What is going on?
My man, I can hear you. It's a bullish sign, dude.
Wow, first time in 3 weeks.
I know. I woke up this morning. I swear, like, as I'm, like, having my, like, donut breakfast, I'm like, yo, I got to update the X app, the Twitter app, so I don't have this issue anymore. But I guess fate was like, don't worry, we got you, Hayden.
Yeah, worked out.
Definitely, dude. How was your week, man? What's cooking? What's new with you outside the world of Hoge to start, man?
Good. Just got done apple picking today. Had some fun over there.
Dude.
Gonna be in an Eagles vodka commercial.
You're in an Eagles vodka commercial?
Yeah, we're tailgating October 1st, the game, and my buddy. So he does the Rocks tequila and Conor McGregor's whiskey, and now the Eagles contact him. They're coming out with a vodka, and they need like a tailgate scene. And you know, obviously, he's my best friend. He's like, "Yo, you want to be in it? Eagles commercial." I was like, "Yep, let's do it."
Oh, dude, that's what's up, man. That's super cool. Like, I know the actor strike's going on, so it's probably not union work, but there's got to be some form of residuals there, dude. I know you've gone viral a time or two. It only makes sense for you to be in this.
Doing some keg stands in the background. That's all I'm good at. No, I'm kidding.
Oh, dude, that's one of the many things you're incredible at. You know, I tried the keg stand thing last weekend. I threw up, you know, in my garage, and I was like, I'm sorry, honey. I am who I am. I won't do that again. But anyways, man, that's really cool. You got to let me know when that commercial comes out. I want to check it. And don't think I didn't catch you slide in apple picking. This is the second week in a row, man. Is this like a regular tradition?
No, I guess we didn't get to go last weekend, so we went this Friday because it ended up raining on Saturday. So it was a one-time thing.
I got you. Well, look, I messed up too. I didn't bring it up to my wife, so this is a reminder. Yo, throw her off at dinner tonight and talk about apple picking. I'm going to do it now, dude. I think it's a sign.
It's super quick. Have a nice bottle of wine. You're good to go.
Dude, you're the goddamn domesticated dad legend I need. But speaking of legend stuff, you're also a Hoge legend, man, and there's been a lot going on this week. What do you got for us this week?
Yes, sir. What is going on, everyone? What an exciting moment in the history of the world. We are living through a true moment of disruption in so many industries. The best thing about paying attention to crypto is that it makes you pay attention to everything else going on. It's truly amazing how it all interlinked and how much easier and more efficient this current system could work. If you tune in here, you know I'm a huge Tesla, MicroStrategy, Bitcoin, and Solana supporter. I really hope you guys are watching the videos coming out about Solana this week and why Visa picked them to test drive their payment network. The statistics around Solana blockchain blow out almost every other network with how it operates, how cheap it is, and how fast it moves. When its Fire Dancer upgrade launches and Solana exits beta, this could be what gets normal people and industry-leading brands into crypto. Many people in the world have no idea that we are in the dot-com era of money and property. Nobody truly understands what digital scarcity means and what trustless ownership means. But once you understand the problems being fixed by these new digital technologies, this is how it has to move. It's moving from the trust system to the truth system. Just make sure you're invested in the right things. We're also in the beginning of the AI era, which basically started in March when ChatGPT-4 came out. Yes, I know, it started before then, but GPT-4 set the stage for so many add-ons and the industry is developing so quickly. And Tesla is the AI play of our generation. If AI is based off data, then they have the most real world data being collected by their millions of cars on the road that will only grow. No one will catch them. And Tesla has X.com for social data for their Optimus Prime humanoid robot. Tesla is not a car company. The sooner you understand that, the faster you will understand what they have built. Imagine someone telling you back in 2001, hey man, Amazon is not an online library. No, bro, you're wrong. It's just books being sold online. Ha ha ha. Well, this is me and a lot of others telling you Tesla is not a car company. It is an artificial intelligence company, an energy company, a space company, and a data collection company. But what it really comes down to is they are the greatest manufacturing company that's ever been created. It took Tesla 12 years to make 1 million cars. And after that, it took 6 months to make 4 million cars. That is exponential growth with a 2 million car backlog. If you're not familiar, there's a new Elon Musk book coming out, and I've been listening to a couple recordings of the author. Elon Musk slept under his desk in the middle of the Gigafactory in Texas for 3 years. He slept under his desk without a mattress so that the workers could see he's not in a shiny tower. He is down there on the work floor with the employees. And if you don't trust a man like that, it's going to get exciting. The Cybertruck is being launched in the next week or two, and they are rolling out a 25K Tesla in China. If you're ever going to own Tesla stock, you need to own it before they nail autonomous driving, which might come by the end of 2023, so less than 4 months. Once that comes out, they will launch the robo-taxi, a car they have designed with no steering wheel or pedals, a luxury transportation experience that can work with no human assistance. Pretty crazy. And that's just like why you need to own Bitcoin before the spot Bitcoin ETFs get approved and regulation is established. Owning Bitcoin before others are able to make a simple phone call to buy Bitcoin, you are early. As a reminder, the earliest the spot ETFs can get approved was September 3rd. and the latest is March 15th. Then we have the halving in April. Many are saying October 16th is a date to pay attention to, but I'm thinking the ETFs come at the start of 2024. Sounds like they want to have it approved at least 100 days before the halving, but I'm just regurgitating people much smarter, what people much smarter than me are saying. If you love listening to crypto YouTube on your drives like me, you need to follow Invest Answers. He is by far my favorite channel. He posts one 25-minute video a day, and it's packed with information. In my opinion, if you're paying attention, we are not going to get a moment like this in our lifetime with so much disruption happening. This is the time to take control of your future. None of this is financial advice. This is just information I'm passing along that I gather weekly. I love researching the topic of disruption being this old because this old system we got now isn't working anymore. And the normal worker is not paying attention and has no idea what is happening behind the scenes. We just added $1 trillion to our debt in America since July. Crazy. AI is here. There is no going back. Blockchain technology is here. Digital ownership is here. Digital scarcity is just starting. You are early, and that's what makes it so much fun. I'm sorry for my rant on disruption. I just want you to understand how truly early we are. Imagine thinking today you're late to Tesla or Bitcoin. Michael Saylor said it best. When was it too late to buy a building in New York? Were you too late in the 1800s? What about the 1900s? What about the early 2000s? No, buying a building in New York has always been a good investment because it's built on granite and a perfectly placed port city on the water. It has always been pristine real estate. Your relatives that have been waiting on the crypto sideline need to get into the game. Do not let them FOMO in like we did on our first bull run. Let them in while it's boring. Get them in while it's boring. And speaking about early, welcome to DeFi. Hoge is a token that is forever unchangeable. The smart contract is value creating and simple to understand. The Hoge brand evolves as its community evolves. We just pulled off a massive community experiment with the MegaVote, passing, which allowed any holders to suggest an idea on how to bring value to Hoge. That idea then was included in the MegaVote. We had 21 different ideas to vote on. Some involved marketing ideas, others were new platforms or products. We had an exchange listing make the list as well. Some just wanted to see the funds held differently. Each community member could then vote on the ideas they thought would bring value to the community. It was a really fun vote. It was successful. We hit quorum by 120%. We had a lot of participation and engagement in the conversation. We had four ideas which would have received funding because they had over 50% of the vote until the last few hours. After some final votes came in, we had only two options earn funding. Both options are very beneficial to the community. If you tuned in last week, I deep dove both ideas. But coming from the MegaVote experiment, Rory was able to see how much potential there is with Snapshot, the voting platform we have always used for our votes. If you go to Reddit and read his post on the future of Hoge governance, it explains everything a lot clearer. The leadership have created a membership group on Snapshot called Hoge Zone. This is an experimental setup, but now theoretically anyone with over 100 million Hoge voting power can create a Snapshot vote. GroupLP and LP are automatically integrated on Snapshot. This solves two of the three options, with crowdfunding being low-hanging fruit to build out on OptiSwap. So if you have an idea you want to have the community vote on, you can join Hoge Zone on Snapshot. The link is in the post on Reddit and propose a vote to the community. We set the floor at 100 million Hoge to allow people with real skin in the game to have the same power as leadership does. And again, leadership's power is just actioning the community's will. But let's talk about the GroupLP Stimulus 2.0, which received the most amount of votes through the MegaVote. This is now active. We launched the first campaign of the second round called We Are So Back to lock up 250 million Hoge and roughly 1.8 ETH. The cool thing about this campaign is the Hoge DAO wallet supplied the 250 million Hoge and then will perform an early withdrawal once the campaign is successful. Currently, the campaign has 1.35 ETH out of the 1.8 ETH goal in under a week. So we almost filled this one in under a week. Once the community fills the remaining ETH, the LP tokens will be purchased and placed into an OptiVault, where they will be soft locked for the agreed upon 2-year lockup period. The HogeDAO wallet will then perform an early withdrawal, paying a 20% fee on 50% of the LP tokens, leaving the remaining campaign participants a 20% starting yield, guaranteed. You heard that right. If you participate in this Group LP campaign, you are getting 20% extra on your contribution. And that yield can only go up if others also early withdraw in the future. But if you hold for the 2 years, not only do you receive the 20% yield, you receive volume fees for providing liquidity. So if Hoge volume really picks up in the bull run like we hope, then you will be earning additional fees on trading volume. Plus, you also receive your Hoge reflections for 2 years. So if you love Hoge and you've never participated in a Group LP campaign, we have already had 14 successful campaigns and increased our liquidity by over 110% as a community with Group LP. You now have another round of campaign starting where you can help give Hoge a future by putting liquidity in hundreds of loyal Hoge holders' wallets. Pretty cool little product we have. And keep in mind, any tokens community can use Group LP to build their liquidity. And if they have a DeFi wallet or marketing wallet, with the early withdrawal feature, they can also guarantee high starting yields for campaign contributors to strengthen their token's liquidity through loyal holders. The second thing that passed with the mega vote is a swapping utility called BonusSwap. BonusSwap is an extremely clever idea suggested by a community member. Since this passed, at the conclusion of the mega vote, we purchased 100 million Hoge to fund this idea. This 100 million Hoge will be put into a specialty swap on OptiSwap, where for a limited time, every time you buy Hoge, you'll receive an extra 4% on your buy. This 4% incentive is to cover your 2% tax on the purchase and your 2% tax on any future sale you make. This 100 million Hoge costs the wallet $1,200 and will give an extra 4% to 2.5 billion Hoge purchased. To be clear, this is not launched yet. The front end bonus swap will go live in early October and you will all be made aware when it is live. And once it is alive, the next 2.5 billion Hoge purchased through bonus swap will receive an extra 4% on top of their buy. These two are pretty awesome ideas. Obviously, we know Group LP works and solves an entire community problem in liquidity. And BonusSwap costs the wallet $1,200 to incentivize 2.5 billion Hoge being purchased. If BonusSwap is a success and it only costs $1,200 for a 4% return, imagine what BonusSwap 2.0 could look like. Let's just say we triple it to $3,600. We can now give a guaranteed 12% return on 2.5 billion Hoge. Wow. Like I said in the beginning, DeFi is just getting started, and Hoge is building things with a community-first mindset. We are built different, and if you're paying attention here, you know that. But others will lump Hoge into every other meme token as if we are the same. Our tokenomics are better than most meme tokens. We have no wasted tax on dev wallets or marketing wallets. Hoge has a pure reflection tax that is unchangeable. We have under 39% of our circulating supply. The community is smart and voting for things that have direct benefits on the community. Nothing is being rushed. Time is the only variable, like Hayden always says. If you're in Telegram, you get to see all of Pump Guard Alex's updates on Hoge AI. If you're here following on Twitter, you get to see the photos as well. And the amount of content Hayden, Looney, and Alex are putting out for the community, it's been fun to see the likes and retweets going up. I want you guys to know the amount of effort it takes to do what you're doing on Twitter does not go unnoticed. The community appreciates it. I appreciate it. It's not easy coming up with content, especially spot on, relevant content like you guys are doing. Backed by custom Hoge animation, it's absolutely so much fun to watch. Anyone following along on Twitter, likes and retweets are free. They do not cost you anything, and they help the Twitter algorithm drastically. So if you see a post about Hoge that you like, give it a like. Give them a retweet. More importantly, if you can throw a comment on there, it helps even more. And it doesn't have to be every tweet, but if you can do it a couple times a week, it adds up. I just paid the $114 yearly fee for my blue check mark on Twitter. So I'm officially verified here on X. When you have this, it helps get the comments higher on posts and more eyes on them. Also, paid marketing is going to start in the very near future as well. I'm going to start slow with putting money behind some of the important TikToks and build as the momentum goes. Our monthly chart is looking strong. The community's having fun and creating. I couldn't be more excited and a bit scared for this coming 6 months. A lot is going to change, and it's going to be a wild ride, but we are here for it. But that's all I got. Back to you, Hayden.
Oh, man, dude, you got a lot. It's another great week with so much going on. And even before diving into the world of Hoge, I mean, super Solana talk, right? Visa choosing to throw them as well into the pilot testing love work here, trying to integrate their on-chain payment systems with them. Now, we know that Visa's been very open and been playing with a handful of L1s, L2s, and just projects and businesses. So they continue to expand and see that it's all about integration with this innovation and not being scared of it, because it's really where the future is going. And of course, as you had said, AI has had a huge year. And you citing Tesla, I mean, that's the company that seems to be synonymous with making machine learning an integral part of all their innovations and tech stacks. And, you know, the man of the hour up top there and here at X, Elon Musk, I did not know, man. New book dropping soon. I am looking forward to reading that one. And it only makes sense that the spot Bitcoin ETF talk continues to heat up and seems to be on the mainstream approval-filled horizons. It's a very bullish sign, guys. But diving into the world of Hoge, the Hoge mega vote was a mega success. And while four ideas were set to push through, two of them, in the end, made it to the community consensus approval finish line. There was that GroupLP incentive program that's renewed, and right after it was, right, they fired up a campaign called We Are So Back, 200 million Hoge, 1.8 ETH, two-year lock period, soft style, and the Hoge DAO wallet with the new incentive program will take that instant early haircut. So the rest of the campaign contributors can start this campaign with that instant 20% yield, on top of all the transaction fees earned and all their, you know, allocations from the burn. It's great with that program. It really does help in an impactful way build the strength of our LP pools. And the other winner was BonusSwap. And I love this idea, and our community did too, subsidizing the cost of the buy and sell tax for the next 2 billion plus Hoge traded. And that equates to receiving an extra 4% on all your Hoge buys, but it will take a special bonus swapper that's dropping on our very own OptiSwap in early October. So stay tuned there for when it rolls out. And then, you know, Jersey, with the thought that it's cost effective enough to come up with ideas like offering maybe more on a bonus swap or 8% or 12% back for minimal operational capital. Another idea to submit to be voted on by our community. And some of the other great builds that have been going on, Hoge AI, which I love, right, continues to get closer to the public launch line with each day that passes. Now, if you're in RTG groups and chats, you've been lucky enough to see all the latest content creations and beta testing updates. And with holiday season around the corner, an automated 24/7 meme-making machine for everyone to play with can only be a good thing for us in the land of Hoge. I mean, content is king, and we've been forming an incredible community-driven and created and managed and maintained team lately. It really takes, you know, dedicated, accountable people into pushing our share of voice everywhere, and I've been having a lot of fun testing and playing with all the Hoge AI pieces of content that I create, you know, learning from Looney on Canva and CapCut and all these places and trying to figure it out, you know, myself and Jersey as well. I mean, this is what it's all about, right? We come from all different parts of the world and walks of life and find that, you know, commonality and alignment for, you know, pushing forward and taking more control right here in the land of Hoge. And you had said down the corner, paid marketing around that street for us. And this is like a first time ever. We got some exciting times ahead that include a paid media budget for the foreseeable future, new product launches, and a community that's here day to day that's actively building, growing, and deploying. Time really is our only variable, and we mean business. So come create with us because Hoge is inevitable, all right? No scratch-off vibes here. There's a lot you can do to invest in yourself before you get into any type of transactional sideline investor life or energy, and that's just the icing on the cake. But Jersey, a lot going on around the horn in Hoge. I know you did the rain check, so you're apple picking this weekend. You got the Eagles. What am I missing? Is there some college buddy night? Is the commercial this weekend? Anything else that you got popping off?
Commercial's next Sunday, but my wife's twin sister is due Sunday.
Boy or girl? So, I forget.
Girl. Little girl. Lena. Yeah, little girl. And my wife's going to be in the delivery room with her. So she feels like it's her too. So it's like any second it could happen.
Are you going to be in the room too?
Yeah, right.
I don't know. Maybe you film, you know, might be a meme.
Yeah, right.
Oh man, dude, hopefully is she delivering that baby on NFL Sunday?
Ideally it comes out pretty soon. And their mom is a delivery nurse. So she's right there the whole time.
Oh, dude, that's awesome, man. If she could deliver that baby on Sunday and you got a babysitter for the kids, that's a good NFL fun day Sunday, my friend.
Yes, sir. But I do want to talk about tomorrow, September 23rd. Have you been hearing anything about this date?
It's a Saturday. It's got a 2 and a 3 in it. What else is there going on?
Dude, there's over like 14 movies that have had major, like, monumental things happening on September 23rd. And there's a lot of like different storylines going. I'm just saying, pay attention tomorrow. See what's going on. If anything weird happens, it's just a very weird date that's been mentioned throughout movie history.
Well, we know movies are all based on nonfiction and they're all the truth, but jokes aside, like, give me one of the weird things, dude. I'm very ignorant and oblivious to this. What's one weird thing I should look out for?
Dude, there's a whole religion thing. There's China invading Taiwan. There's alien. Like, we're getting this tech. There's so many different things, but nobody knows what this date means, but something crazy is supposed to happen tomorrow. You know, I like my conspiracies. Theories. I like to follow these and pay attention, and it's exciting. And I just wanted to know if you had heard anything about it.
No, but now you're going to make me look, and like, you know, all I'm looking forward to Saturday morning, right, is some McDonald's breakfast, a bacon, egg, and cheese McGriddle, 6 shots of espresso, get back before I go out and do some basketball. My son's got a game, you know, maybe get a little bed wars in with them because they got me into the game and now I like it. So now I got to worry about some weird stuff happening and some Matrix blue pill, red pill. Now I got anxiety. That's going to only increase, you know, my alcohol intake this evening so I can feel less. It's a gift and a curse, Jersey. Thank you for this information.
I mean, at least you've been warned, but I do hope it's a normal Saturday because if it's going to go the way it's going to go, some shit is going down.
Oh, man. All right. Well, let's hope for, you know, the blue-pilled reality that Neo was living in for a while, at least through my bacon, egg, and cheese McGriddle. I'm really looking forward to those syrup pockets of flavor, my friend, and just want to keep it simple. But as always, man, appreciate you coming on. There's a lot going on around the horn in our world, and the gift is, right, that we're not playing the shill game, just trying to get token volume. So most people are looking away because everyone's here for that transactional, quick, you know, come up and meme tokens, they're all having their run right now in some way, shape, or form. But we're building the forever product suite that's really going to matter in a mature, regulated industry. We're not just here with our main goals and KPIs here for the fleeting moment of the speculator's landscape. We're here for the forever part of it, taking this tech, integrating it, and turning it into meme business-infused, everyday, integral products, experiences, and education. And with people like you here, Jersey, we got a damn good shot being set up for success. So thanks again for coming on and looking forward to running it back with you again next week, my friend. All right.
Yes, sir. Have a good weekend.
You too. Go Birds. Go McNabb and T.O. I want to see them really crush it this weekend. But anyways, not going back to the past, coming back to the future. It's the Jalen Hurts era. But hey, I'll never forget the T.O. McNabb era. That was a time. Anyways, look, efficient show here today. The man of the hour of X and Tesla is Elon, the Magic Musk man. So I got something he said that really just resonates, you know, here in the land of Hoge and really just in this moment that we're all in right now. And he said, there have to be reasons that you get up in the morning and you want to live. Why do you want to live? What's the point? What inspires you? What do you love about the future? And I love these questions that he's asking because they have logical answers in the sense of you might not know what that answer is, but these are the things that you look in the mirror at yourself, by yourself, in the middle of the night and ask. You know, our time is limited and ticking away. And a lot of us, we got to do what we got to do. We got responsibility. So maybe we can touch the do what we want to do era of our lives. But with every day that you have and every second that you get to spend here on this earth, you got to be focused on your wants, your goals, your desires, and have that complement whatever you have to do during the day. And it's just a reminder to me to ask what I'm doing here. What's the point? What moves me? And how do I find a way to make it work and take care of my responsibilities, my family, my loved ones, and everything else that I have an appetite for? And I think if we were all to ask ourselves these questions, things would become clear. And while you might get a clear answer of what moves you and what doesn't, you get that feeling in your gut, that intuition, that's your answer, right? And now the challenge is figuring out the equation to get that result with the pieces and the setup that you have here today. Too many people are on autopilot, just getting through the day to have that 2 hours on the couch and drink a beer and forget about it for 2 days on the weekend to wake up with a hangover to get to your coffee and just, you know, barely get through the week. But we have our health, we have our wealth, we have our direct access to innovation, technology, the internet, information, AI, free tools. And most of the world is sleeping on this. We don't have to be the sleepers. And that's what I love about the land of Hoge. And if more of us were to question what we're doing here and what moves us, I think you get to a real climate of figuring out what that is and act accordingly. Time is the only variable until we all end in this world. So make the most of it while you still can. And let's meme some business together. But a lot going on in our world. A lot of good stuff. Hoge AI, Q4, holiday season. GroupLP campaign, round two. I saw they got a couple new other projects from around the tokenized communities to come in. I mean, that is a fun gamified game changer. So as you go into your weekend, think about your game changers, your X factors. Remember, insanity is doing the same thing over and over again, but expecting different results. So maybe it's time to change your process, your flow, the way that you make your decisions. Because time is ticking away. Optimize. Figure it out. There will never be another moment like this again. Take advantage, sending good vibes, and until next week, we'll run it all the way back. Take care, everybody.